The guest rooms, where my father, all our entourage, and I should have passed the night, lay cold and silent. The sands of time had swept through, stealing life and warmth from everything they touched. And I, who unleashed the cataclysm, had been spared. Were there others like me, who yet clung to life, hiding in fear among the ruins? It did not seem so. Had I really seen her? Or had my senses given way under the burden of horrors too great to bear and conjured up a phantom? Either way, I could not rest until I had found her again. I'll start the story from here next time. Whence came these visions that assaulted me thus, like fever dreams? Each time I awoke feeling drained and beaten. And each time, what I had seen came to pass. as if the sands of time were giving me a glimpse into my own future. I had experienced by accident in the Maharaja's treasure room, I now discovered that I could trigger at will. By pressing a switch on the dagger's handle, I could turn back time.
Zard anymore. Water.
What just happened? That's strange. I feel wonderful.
My father turned to sand.
And we will share his fate if you do not give me the dagger to undo what you have done.
Your traitorous vizier used the same words. From now on, I trust no one but myself. Run! Go back to the reception hall. Wait for me there. Go!
Now I remembered her. Since we left India, she had been there. In the desert, I had felt her dark eyes upon me. Now, here she was again. She and I, the only two survivors. Did I say two? Excuse me. We were three. The hourglass. What? I did not understand the meaning of what I had just seen, but I knew, with a certainty I could not explain, that those winged creatures had a master. The man who had tricked me into opening the hourglass now had his prize. And for some unknown purpose coveted the dagger as well, would stop it nothing to possess it. Well, I would give him what he sought. I would plunge it into his foul and treacherous heart. digging deeper with the dagger of time, I began to realize why the vizier wanted it so badly. I'll start the story from here next time.
Oh, thank God! I was afraid you were one of them! Can you help me activate the Azard defense system? It'll take both of us to do it! I'll reset the axles for you! The man who's normally in charge of this got... Never mind! Ride the platform down to the bottom, then use those two cranks to bring it back up! You see those four axles? You'll need to pick them up one by one until you've got all four. Then, bring them up to the top together. Make sure you pick them up in the right order. That's it! You've got the first axle! Now, pick up the other three! Remember, pay attention to the grooves! That's it! One crank turns the platform! The other one raises and lowers it! That's two! Just one more! Top and line them up with their gears. You've almost got it. Just line up the axles with their gears. Now, There's one last step! Do you see that platform? Throw your lever, and I'll throw mine!
What manner of machine is this?
I told you! It's the palace's defense system! Stop wasting time! Throw your lever! For the love of God, what are you waiting for? Those demons might come back at any moment! Those accursed demons, right? Oh, by God, they'll rue the day they ever dared attack the palace of Azard!
I'll start the story from here next time.
What have I done?
The palace's defenses had a twisted logic of their own. They could be circumvented by using the strategically placed switches which I soon learned to recognize. Yet it was hard to escape the feeling that I had made a terrible mistake by setting in motion such a deadly system of traps, which seemed in truth more likely to claim my life than that of an invader that was not flesh and blood. I'll start the story from here next time.